Take another chance.
Hello again, little ones. It's Auntie Kathleen here once again. And this afternoon, it's the story of little Nobby. And,
I'm sorry, madam. They told me Mr. Murray was come with the car. Now he's going
before... Oh, dear. I think that I've actually come to the wrong studio. But, oh, my gracious me, I think I ought to pack all my scripts up. I was going to do Nobby, but obviously this is not the right studio. Oh dear, what will Henry say?
Mr. Murray?
I'm not here.
They've got the men outside there for the parking fine.
Why I say I'm not here.
You tow the car away.
I'm right? Not here. You what?
Said you will tow it away.
Gracious me, yes, I'm here. Just a moment.
Address any queries to Mr. Preston Furstershires in Pretoria. Our interviewer on controversial affairs, Mr. Gert Ockert.
I didn't know you were going to introduce me. Oh, you know, I'm interested to know, Mr. Flaunchley, why the petrol is still so scarce. It's a big question.
Well, scarcity is mere kale at present in total plentitude of Glen Tendrilly. Max Tafel at Glen Gentrick is at four glance plentitude. In common, of course, with business practice.
Oh, I see, yes. But wasn't there talk of a settlement with those petrol countries?
Yes, but not in Gantrophy or Blanctifort. Candastras is built in Drethan on the Cambic Expansula and calls for instant throw-bys before clipping. It's unusual to pattern a plexitude of Munstifer for long periods, but yesterday it was Castifer.
Have you finished? Oh, yes. Clastifer is what?
Well, no Crinstamere can forebridge the Glondifers of crop Winchsterfields in spring, but the few Andropomelstifers have been awarded the same amount of Grand Prix as Pastonshoes.
Well, I would say then that just about sort of sums it up. And to sum up again, I think we can all see that petrol rationing seems to be with us for a while. I'd like to thank you, Mr. Flaunchley, for coming on the programme and explaining this point so carefully and clearly to us.
Thank you.
Much appreciated.
Periscope. A look at unsung heroes in the SABC, like Reception.
Oh, I haven't seen the foyer to the old SABC for quite some time after being away on my little holiday. Hello, Miss Ninaver. Hello. Any post for me? Mr. Murray. Hello, Esme. How are you? My goodness, you're looking well. Gracious, still with that little dog, eh, Miss Ninaver? Esme, I mean.
I don't think there's any
post
for you, Mr.
Murray. Hello. Have you got any mail for me, perhaps? Mervyn John. I'm playing tunes this afternoon.
Hello, Mervyn. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Your paper, Mervyn.
Thank you very much, Miss Ninaver.
Gracious, all these people coming up to the county here, Miss Ninaver. I suppose it's like working on a film set with all the stars popping in and out, and you know.
Oh, we the Trammel. I mean, oh, sorry, but you know, honestly, sometimes we really have it like a Grand Central Park station.
Yes, right? I know. Have you got any messages for me there, perhaps?
Hold on one second, I'll just check.
Hello, Eric. Oh, I suppose the telephone drives you mad,
honestly,
too.
Honestly, with one after the other, there are three telephones here, and they all ring at the same time, you know.
Hello, Virgil.
Hello, Colin. How are you?
Very well. Have you got any mail for me, please? There should be a telegram, I think.
Just hold on, Mr. Duplessis. I'll just check.
So, are you keeping well, then? You're looking very fine and fit.
Yes, now I'm fine. I've had a lovely holiday, thank you.
I don't think you see. It doesn't look like there's anything for you, Mr.
Oh, gracious. All right, well, I'll be up on the fifth floor.
All right, fine.
Cheerio.
Bye.
My goodness me, yes, one sees everybody down here in the foyer, doesn't one?
Oh, good afternoon. I was wondering if there was some mail for me. I've just come up to do a big fat session of jukebox, you know.
How are you, Mr. Talker? Are you well?
Good afternoon, Mr. Talker.
Well, you know, what happened was that I got a bit tied up this morning around about tea time over at one of the studios and decided that I'd go across the road for some lunch.
I
got tied up at the studio.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. Did you, are you still doing Mr. Talker Wants to Play?
Well, not at the moment, Voter, but I'm very tied up at the moment with jukebox and other programs, and especially other record shows and tunes.
Yes, yes, I'm sure you are.
I
still
don't
a very
think
busy
this,
man.
Anything for you, young Mr. Talker?
Good morning to you. Good morning, good morning. Hello, Voter. How are you? It's jolly nice to see you all here. Hello, Mr. Talker. Hello, Miss Ninava. Have you got any mail for me? Robin is the name. And you should find me over there under A. What a lovely basing day it is today, isn't it? Just lovely.
I thought it was rather cold and chilly this morning.
No, 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 nonsense. You know, you have to be up, really, with the birds, 5 o'clock in the morning, and it's really jolly D. It really is. Oh, well.
I don't think it's anything for a Rachni to be held on, Robin. I see.
Oh, yes. Ah, me. Don't mind if I sort of do a little run on the spot, will you?
Not at all, no, but you must be very energetic.
Oh, I like to keep good and fit, you know. Ah, yes. Ah, yes, Mrs. A's little boy. No mail for me. Oh, what a pity. Anyway, I must be on flight, eh?
Okay, cheerio. Cheerio, chaps. Goodbye. He's got the
My goodness me, what an incredible dynamo, almost a volcanic eruption of energy there, I would say. Well, bye-bye then, Mrs. Peabody.
Cheerio, Mr. Talker. Gracious me, still just the same, isn't he, Miss Ninava?
I actually thought he was in Australia.
Well, I did too. I didn't know he was back here.
Well, perhaps he's just come back for a weekend or something like that.
Yes, that's very likely, yes.
Well, there's nothing here for you.
All right, let me just sign in the book here. Time of arrival. Right there. Name, address. I'll just put care of Ferndale Nurseries then, shall I? And who to see? Well, I'm here actually to record. I'm recording in 3B. Right, you are. Oh, and by the way, if you see Nan Fletcher, do tell her that I appreciate the magnolias that you sent around. Very sweet of her.
No, but I definitely will do that, Mr. Murray. Honestly, you
Thank
know, I
you
must
so
say
much.
You're looking so spruced up and like a new pin these days.
Don't you like my new cigarette holder? Isn't that lovely?
Very nice.
Present from Barbara McFudgeon.
Lovely.
Made
very
of ivory, eh, Matt?
Oh.
You haven't got a match, have you? While I fill in the form, yeah?
I love it, Matt. Okay. Yes, I think we can manage this.
Thank you so much. Gracious me, but the forms here seem to have changed. You remember it always used to just say, time in, who you've seen, what your name is, what your address is, and what your purpose of business is. Now they've got a question here, like, for example, what is the color of my hair? Well, what color would you say my hair is? A sort of a sandy...
Know, Mr. Murray, it's a sort of, I would think something like a...
Well, a few grey hairs, of course, yes. But I mean, it's overall sort of a sandy color, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I think, you know, perhaps if one were to summarize it in one word, a sort of, perhaps mossy color, you know?
Mossy colored.
Yeah.
Oh, I tell you what, I'll write that down here just for laughs. Mossy colored, right? Look at this, what color eyes? Well, everybody can see I've got green eyes.
Yes, a greeny gray.
Green eyes. Yes, you remember that, Miss Nienhauer? And, but this is all ridiculous. I want to know my height in centimeters. I don't know what my height in centimeters is.
Now, hold on 1 second. We've got a tape measure here, Mr.
Murray. Oh, this is ridiculous. Why do they want to know all these details just for me? Look, I've got to go in and record a program. I can't stand here filling in all these details here.
No, well, it's just that... They're far more fussy about having a comprehensive entry form, you know, about when they come to the SABC.
All right, well, now, but you want me to take my shoes off?
No, just take your shirt off so that I make sure that I...
By what? I am not standing here bare-chested in the foyer of the SABC without my shirt on?
We have to, Mr. Murray. Honestly, it's just one of the new rules that have come through, so if you can just quickly take your shirt off...
I totally refuse. I totally refuse.
Come on,
I totally
Mr.
refuse.
Murray, really,
I totally
it.
Refuse. What do you think you're doing? Let go of me! Look what you've done. You're tearing my shirt, Miss Ninava. For goodness gracious sake. Oh, no. How can I go into the building now like this with my shirt?
I'm sorry. I'm terribly sorry you there, Mr. Murray, but what else could I do? We've got to get on with the people.
Oh, you and your tape measure and everything else.
I'm sorry. Now, hold on a second now.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I make it about 84 centimeters.
I don't care what you make it. You made me drop my cigarette and I burnt a hole here in the fence of my...
46 centimeters from the waist.
You slacks.
And then the head measurement itself.
But look at me. I mean, look at my shirt. I'm standing and I feel completely ridiculous.
How are you there? Good morning, everybody.
Oh, no.
How are you?
Morning, Charles.
Hello there, Mr. Bury. My goodness, what are you having? A sun down in the foyer here?
Charles, don't try and be funny. Honest. Can't you see what they've done? They've torn my shirt into shreds.
Just line up there, please, Mr. You have been completely filled in there, Mr. Murray. You can go up here. Who are you visiting?
I'm going to record in 3B. That's what I'm going to do. How can I go into 3B now with my shirt all in shreds? I'm so embarrassed. I could just pop off.
All you
right
need
now.
To, all you need to do is just fill in a form 314-312 and for damaged clothing or clothing.
Yes, give me the form. I'll fill it in right now. Right. No, I'll take it with me and fill it in. I take a very serious view of this right now.
All right, but
is the lift working? No, I don't suppose it is because the lift never does work. Well, anyway.
No, I think the lifts are working, Mr. Murray. We'll see you anyway when you come down.
Look at me. My shirt is all in a complete mess. And this lift door is like getting into an old guillotine. Gracious, this lift should be in a museum. Well, mind you, on second thoughts, I suppose it is. Now, third floor. Right, here we go. A ridiculous lift. If I ever get to the third floor, I'll be lucky. I suppose there'll be a guard or somebody waiting for me at the third floor trying to take my measurements again or something ridiculous or have me x-rayed. So here we are. I don't know how anybody has never damaged themselves getting in and out of these lifts. Now, 3B, where is that? That's along here.
Good afternoon.
Mr. Faulkner, hello. You must please excuse me. I'm totally, well, I nearly said ridiculous, but I'm very embarrassed. My shirt is all torn.
It doesn't look as though you have much on at all, does it, under the circumstances? But anyway, may I ask who you are?
Oh, yes, I'm sorry. You and I have never actually met before. I'm Marie, Voter Marie. Very pleased to meet you.
Yes, well, I'm afraid I haven't heard that name before. Would you please mind reporting to the reception desk?
What did you say? Oh, I'm sorry. And now it's time for Barbara McFudgeon and her canopies and recipes.
I've often wondered what would happen if... I've often wondered what would happen if one decided to combine the ethnic and essential gastronomic characteristics of two countries. But so often, because the differences are so vast, the advance towards what could, I suppose, be called eclectic eating has been, for the moment at least, temporarily delayed. However, what I would like to relate is a rather quaint combination of two different colours, chosen, I would think, at complete random from the Epicurean spectrum, and blended together in what at least must be described as a pretty adventurous entry into culture crossing at the dinner table. The countries chosen were China and South Africa, as it so happens, and what was perhaps even more strange to accept at first was that the Chinese meal was an evening one and South Africa's was breakfast. It may sound a little far-fetched, but I believe that the results were not only unusual, but quite overwhelming. The name of the dish is sweet and sour curried sausage fritters. Now, this is how to go about it. In a small bowl, combine 2.5 teaspoons of soya sauce, 2.5 teaspoons of white vinegar, 2.5 teaspoons of sugar, 1.5 teaspoons of sesame seed oil, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and 1/2 tablespoon of melted bubble gum. Bring quickly to the boil and simmer for a while until you hear a plopping sound. Then you quickly add 1 teaspoon of baking powder and 4 tablespoons of flour. Boil for another 2 minutes and then fry for another 12. Now, when your mixture is a sort of golden goo, gently fold in small slices of cold curried boerewors, which you've soaked overnight in a marinade of either lemon and lime or cream and soda. You gently add 4 pounds of melted butter and then grill it to fantastic heat for about an hour or until a sickeningly sweet smell fills the kitchen or wherever you're cooking this dish. You then cut into 6 fairly sizable fritters and you serve ice cold. It is a breakfast dish, but does work very well, my friend assures me, as a companion to morning tea. The kitchen, of course, can be temporarily redeemed with 1 or 2 long sprays from an air freshener, and we would like to remind you that the fritters are not suitable for small children.
A speedster was speeding in Joburg.
He was wasting his petrol like mad.
With his foot on the gas, he was racing. He said...
Racing's a buzz for me, Dad.
A speed cop, angry and bossy, raced after this monstrous old sucky. He said...
What's it to me?
It's a summons for thee.
And your quarters, battle-proof bucky.
It's so peppy, you sometimes forget about speed restrictions.
Quarters! Quarters!
Quarters, battle-proof bucky. Scoop up and it...
The rooms of Dr. Gert Ockert, specialist psychiatrist.
Oh, my goodness me, but it's hot today. Whew. This water tastes like nectar. Oh. Come in! Come in! Nearly choked on the water. Come in! Come. Good heavens! You nearly broke the door down.
Whoa!
Here in my diary it says Van Bredaar. Huh? Van Bredaar is written here in my diary. Are you Van Bredaar?
Yeah, you know.
Good morning.
These
sit down.
People
I see
are all
already sitting.
By madmen.
Oh, it's hot, isn't it? Would you like some water? Oh, no, I can't stand this noise.
What's that?
Just a moment.
These people are mad around here.
You people out there, stop making all this noise! The people in the waiting room. There's one out there that thinks he's Billy Vroom. Now then.
Ridiculous. Listen. Oh. You know what? I'm mad, man. Raving, stark, raving mad.
Really? You know, I feel like that sometimes about myself, too. Why, what makes you think this?
Well, I came...
This office is so stuffy.
I was thinking on the way here today, all over through the way
the
here.
The air conditioning is not working, you see.
Yeah. Oh. I can feel it myself.
Yeah. I think if I let's open the window. Yes, no. Where do you come from, Mr. Van Bredaar? Is it Brakpan? Is it according to what I've got in my diary? Brakpan.
No, I'm mad.
I see you're carrying a guitar. Do you play the guitar?
No, I just carry it, but I'm mad. You know?
Yes, but do you play it?
Well...
No, but I mean, can't you... Oh, listen to that Billy Vaughan out there in the waiting room again. Can't you play tunes and melodies? I mean, don't you take the guitar seriously?
No, I don't mind if I don't take it seriously. I'm just mad. I want to come see you about that.
I see, yes. Well, now, first of all, tell me, why do you think this?
Well, I can explain why I'm mad.
Mm-hmm.
One day I just sat down in the,
Yes?
I've got loss of memory.
Yeah?
And I went mad. Uh-huh. You know?
How long ago was this?
About four years ago.
Oh, yes?
Mm.
And do you like these little sweets with the red stripes on them? You have one.
Mm.
They're very nice. Do you like them? Now, well, what sort of... Are you married?
I was married last year.
Yeah?
Got married again this year and next year. And...
And the year after?
Mm.
Ah, I see, yes. I'm just making notes.
Now, listen,
here.
I came to see you because
I know. I'm just taking notes here, really. My goodness me, I suppose we're lucky that we don't have Winifred Atwell or Charlie Kuntz out there in the waiting room as well. Now, look here. Where are you going? Come in!
Mr. Ockert,
Yes, Dr. Orchid.
Yeah, well, listen, they, do you want me to, what must I do about all those loonies out there in the waiting room?
Hey? Well, please take the saxophone away from the one, please, really, otherwise, you know this ledge outside my window here, I'm going to go and stand there and close the window and I'm going to just be quiet and on my own for a while. I can't stand this anymore. You're all making me muddled and confused.
But listen.
Go and take his saxophone away immediately. Can't you see I'm busy here with Mr. Funbadar? Mr. Funbadar, will you come back, please, from the cupboard? No, don't look in the cupboard, please. It's got nothing to do with you.
Hold
no, that's just a skeleton. Now, leave that skeleton alone. Oh, my goodness.
Mr. Orchid, hold on a second. If no, I if don't chuck those people out...
The skeleton is going to pull it apart, and then the bones will be all over the place. Right. And it's happened 14 times in this past week already. That's right. No, just leave the skeleton alone. Now, Mr. Funbadar, sit down again, please. I'm sorry about that interruption.
Listen, don't worry about this. I know I'm mad.
Oh,
well. I know I'm mad. I'll see
and
you next week.
I have got such a sore throat, you wouldn't believe it. Oh!
Was that jelly to bring tea?
No. Just tell her that I'm going away for a while. If anybody wants me, I shall be out on this little ledge outside talking to the birds.
Tony, your trip to Tennessee, interesting? Never have I been more overwhelmed than when I saw in live concert Jolly Jeannie Murphy and the Hicksters at the Green Flower Club in Memphis. Here was true country, not merely the songs of the people and the peasants, but the warm glow of the balladeer who really lived and breathed for the Mid and Southwest, a feeling which pervades even to this day. And whether it's the Paddy Whackers, Jug Band, or Johnny Cash, it's great country.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine.
And so, in tribute to country music on the English service, I would like you to hear my rendition of He'll Have to Go. Are the microphones set up?
Are the microphones set up? Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down
low.
And you can tell your friend how with you you'll have to go.
And now until tomorrow, this is Tony saying bye.
I'm sorry. Excuse me, madam.
Oh, you gave me quite a fright. Yes?
Well, they want to...
This tea is too terrible. Can't you do something about it?
No, they want to clear out the studio, you know?
But I can't, my dear man. I can't leave the studio just yet. I'm still busy filling in the forms.
Yeah, but my boys want to...
Look at all these forms here. Look at this. That's... 213 stroke E. That's stroke G. That's stroke. Now, how did that get there? That's stroke X. But you can see I've got all these forms to fill in. I can't just get up and leave the studio. So there you are. I'm sorry. And I've got to contend with this terrible tea. Would you like a cup of tea?
No, I've got to clean. I'm sorry. I've got to.
Here you are. Don't be silly. Have a lovely cup of tea. There you are. Listen to me calling it lovely tea. I mean, really, it isn't. It's awful tea. It's horrible tea.
Oh, no, but I'm sorry. They must go now. The boys must clear up, you know?
Oh, well, what have I done with my... Can you see my handbag anywhere? Oh, there it is over there. Won't you just pass it to me, please? It's really rather like a sort of a portmanteau, isn't it? But, you know, one has got to have a large handbag to carry all one's odds and ends around in.
Yes,
no? No, don't drop it. I've got a spare pair of dentures in there.
But
you know how, and you know what they cost these days, really. I don't want you to break them.
No, well, I'm sorry to chase you out, you know what I mean?
No, it's quite all right. You just take all my forms and things. I didn't want to fill in the forms anyway, I can assure you. And these shoes are killing me.
I'm sorry, you don't know.
I've got bunions, you know that. Everyone has a bunion. It's too terrible.
Yeah. I'm sorry to ask you, you know, but we've got quite a timetable here, really. When we clean out this place, I would say sometimes 3 times a day, you know. And when somebody's in here, I'm simply about to ask them whether they'll be prepared to leave, you know.
Oh, I just remembered. You know what I've done? Please come with me, help me. I was looking after Esme's little dog, and I had it here with me, and I don't know what I've done with it. Can't you turn the lights on or something?
Oh,
my goodness me, I had it here. It's not under the table. It's not
you know, we're not
table.
Allowed to have animals.
Won't you ever look? What?
We're not allowed to have animals in the building.
No, it's Esme's little dog. I was just looking after it for her. She's gone
but I don't think we're allowed to have
she's gone to South America, animals in somewhere. Perhaps it's behind the amplifier. You know, it's a tiny little dog. It's a very small dog. You must... have you ever seen it before?
No, but dogs and cats
are not...
No,
but please, just turn on the lights, please,
all
because
right.
It must be here somewhere.
Hold on
we
a
might
second.
Step on it or something.
I'll switch on the light. There we are. Oh, there it is over here. There we are.
Oh, you dear, sweet little thing.
All right.
Thank you so much. Really, I don't know what I would have told Esme if I had it.
Well,
I just might have left the poor little thing in there, all on his little nose.
What do you do here at the SABC, madam? What do you do here at the SABC?
I'm a coordinator.
Coordinator. Well, I'm sorry, we have to go now, you know. I haven't seen you around here before.
No, but I've been around here often.
Where did you go?
I've been around here for the last 28 years or so.
Are you one of the announcers?
Well, not really, no. I don't like announcing.
Good.
You know, I'm not... you know, to be an announcer, one is what would be a rather extrovert type of person, you know. I'm not that way myself.
Anyway, well, thanks. I'm sorry, we're going to clean up, eh? Bye-bye then, madam.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Mr. von Jarschfeld, we've only got 4 boys tonight, and I've asked the requisition for more to clean up, and I'll give you a call in the morning. Thanks.
Dr. Tango, what do you recommend for ingrown toenails?
But I've tried the own about the sand wraps, but I couldn't have told the wraps to him with Prats, my own friends, you know.
Listen, can I speak to you privately about it? Because I haven't been on the show now for about 3 or 4 weeks, you know. And so I wanted to know if I'll give you a call in the morning. Is that all right?
Please do, yes.